Welcome to the Harvard Kennedy School, School of Public Policy and Government, in Cambridge, Massachusetts.
Every year, hundreds of students come here to learn how to make public policy, how to fix their country's economy, health and education systems, but mostly to drink aguardiente. Many important people study here. Barack Obama, Natalie Portman, Matt Damon,
and even my husband, Antonio Pablo Fernando A. Salazar.
Today, we will discover what the students are doing in the MPA ID, the Master in Public Administration for International Development. What are the fears? What are the hopes? But most importantly, what has been my husband doing the last 2 years? Join me in this journey when we will learn about their goals, ambition, and addictions. Here I will interview the most prominent students, well, the ones that accepted my invitation. My name is Antonella Llevaretti, and this is... What is this?
We don't have a name, just say something.
The documentary about people.
The MPA ID is a program that lasts about 2 years. There are 80 and plus students, and it lasts 18 courses. But here is where everything started.
When I think back on math camp, the first thing that comes to mind is Alejo telling me that I was in a study group with like Alejo, Johan, and Roshi, and I thought we were all getting on great, everyone was laughing at my jokes, and then it was only this year that Alejo told me that he and Johan couldn't understand anything I was saying the whole time. So that was one learning from Math Gap.
I remember thinking, I'm an engineer, I can handle the math, so I'm going to be okay. And then when we started our regular classes, I was not okay. The econ was way too hard, and I had no idea what was happening. But luckily for me, there were several really wonderful friends who let me copy their homework, and I was able to get through the program.
And very awkward situations where we didn't know each other and we were trying to pretend to like each other.
I remember everybody being very concerned about those problem sets that we weren't even graded on, and I remember a lot of fun parties. I think we had all this post-COVID energy that we unleashed, and that has disappeared this year.
A lot has changed between the first year and the second year in that in the first year we had a lot to complain about. We were complaining all the time about like why we have all these core classes and they're making us do so much math, but honestly I think there was so much of togetherness. There's something about having the same things to complain about. And I think in the second year, we all kind of took different courses. I didn't take many courses that are a lot of this. So I heard everyone complaining about like their leadership classes and everyone had the same things to complain about housing, but I was not in any of those classes. So I was really sad because my complaints are now different from your complaints.
In the first semester, we have macro, statistics.
Wait, you have two micros?
No, micro and macro.
I don't see the difference. Micro and micro.
Micro and macro.
They're the same.
They're a bit different. I think macro, we talk more about Argentina's currency crisis.
The first year was very much intense because I was actually here in the US for the first time, and the style of teaching that I was used to is somehow different from what I experienced here. And a lot of theoretical work in the first year.
Okay. Hey, group six.
There's our plan. The right one.
Yeah, just go, yeah.
He tried?
Our plans are really bad. What's up? How are you?
Whoa! That was awful.
Okay.
No, man, where are you?
Wow. Yeah. Gosh, with care.
It is incredible to think that I'm standing here in a building where the most powerful, most successful, and richest people on earth studied. It is incredible because it's unbelievable. That place is in the other side of the river, Harvard Business School. It's a fucking dangerous place. You cannot walk around without being asked for a coffee chat or to a networking event.
The difference between HKS and HBS is that HKS people have a heart and HBS people do not.
I would say that the MBA program is very transparent in terms of aligning people's desires for money and power. And I think that the MPA ID is much more sneaky about it. And so this is a way for us to gain status and power while saying that we're actually working for development, making the world a better place, etc., etc.
They have money, we don't have money. That's the main difference between the MBA and the MPID, I would say. They get to party hard, go to fancy trips, and here we are. We get to hunt around free food.
At the end of the first years, the students have to spend their summer doing a summer internship. I've only seen pictures of amazing places and beaches, but little is known about the hard work and sacrifice they do.
So the internship for the MPID program is an opportunity to apply the things you've been learning. But I think that it means something different to different people. So some people are really looking to get a job in a certain organization or maybe move into a different sector, a different type of role for after they once they graduate. But for a lot of people, it's just an opportunity to see a new place or do something fun. Have a summer with your friends or a chance to hang out on the beach for a couple months before you go back to class and then eventually get stuck maybe in an office for for a long time.
So we're all here to learn how to make this world a better place, and the internship is designed to help us test that out and maybe apply some of the learnings that we're supposed to have learned in the MPID first year. And we're supposed to go to developing countries.
Oh, I went to Geneva.
I went to Dubai, UAE.
Paris.
I did my internship in New York.
I went to Berlin, Germany.
I was staying in Boston.
Once the summer is over, students come back to finish their classes for the second year.
So in the MPA ID, we have the process of the first year we take core, and then the second year we have more flexibility. And for me, as someone who comes from a country with dictatorship, having the choice in the second year was very frustrating.
It's great. We have the beginning, each student has 1,000 points. So my strategy was, okay, I will bet anything, everything that I have to the courses that I want to get into, 500. And the cool thing is that you will get some points in return.
If a class has more demand than supply, it goes to bidding. And when it goes to bidding, you get to allocate the different 1,000 points you have to the different classes. So you have different strategies. You can either put all of your points in one class, knowing that you would be increasing the price, or you can put the same number as last year's price for this product, and then you would be, you know, assuming a random force, like yesterday's price, today's price is going to be yesterday's price plus some kind of random error, which doesn't always work out. Or you just, you know, cry and don't bid on anything, which is what I did in my first semester of the second year.
Yes, so the bidding process at this school is sort of like an unconditional cash transfer, where everybody is given the same amount of money and only you can use that money. And so it's much less efficient than an American capitalist system, where you should be able to sort of exchange the points with other people, and instead you're sort of forced to use like a scarce resource only for yourself.
What really worries a second year MPAD, it's a new enemy that grows to unexpected pain and suffering. I'm talking about SAIPA.
So as for the definition, it's the capstone project of MPID, and where we are expected to maybe put into practice what we have learned so far and give recommendations to real or imaginary clients. Yeah, like that's the definition.
SAIPA is a devil, but it is on. There are so many emotions from me right now thinking about SAIPA.
You know, you only learn from failures, and I think that's what SAIPA is trying to teach us. That's what SAIPA is trying to give us, like a failure experience, so we grow like stronger.
I thought I didn't have any fears, but after SAIPA, I have many. It was painful, scary, and I still dream about it. But I'm going to therapy, so that's something I'm working on.
I completely, you know, like, initially I was, more ambitious, but in the end, what I try to do is just to get things done.
I wish I could delete that experience of my life. It was horrible. I'm not speaking with my parents. I'm not speaking with my friends. I lost my partner. It was horrible.
I started to drink. I went to some other ways to cope with that experience.
Can you imagine? My mom told me this morning, hey, what happened to your parties? There's no party this weekend. And I was like, mom, you're right, because you know, before the spring break, we had SAIPA. So there was no parties for the last 2 weeks of the SAIPA. Can you imagine that in the MPID cohort? My mom was shocked to the core, that she had to ask me, hey, what happened to your parties? So that's what SAIPA does. It takes people away.
Sometimes you don't have the data, so you have to do something about that.
No, and when you see that the numbers don't go to anyone, you start to do kind of cherry picking. And that's the sad truth of development. It's all cherry picking.
That's so sad.
So sad.
But it's true.
But it's true.
To finish their side pass, the students spend many, many hours here in the student lounge. They got a nice sofa, a nice TV,
even a piano. But more importantly, they can... Where the fuck is your coffee?
Have so many pictures about Tomás sleeping. I can make an album. Actually, I want to make an album. I want to make an album by the end of the program. I have no idea. And I don't remember if he did this in undergrad. Like, I don't know if it's a Tomás thing. I don't know if it's an H thing. I have no idea. But yeah, I
I've seen people sleeping in the couches in the forum, especially I've seen like more than a couple of times Tomás sleeping with his laptop, and I've seen Tai also, so they look so cute sleeping.
Everybody sleeps. If you don't want to sleep, even if you are tired, I don't know why you don't do it. It's going to improve your, your productivity, and if you are as embarrassed of people watching you like sleeping, I mean, you have been drumming many parties, and that's even worse than just doing something like it's really natural from sleeping. So I think that I do what people really want to do, but I don't know, they don't want. I don't care.
Hey, I had a bad day, and I wondered how it tastes. So I ate, and then I served myself a second plate. Hey, I had a bad week.
Free food is a public good. So as a public good, it gets to be like common. It suffers of the tragedy of the commons. So because it's free, it's attractive to people, and we're students, so we don't receive income anymore.
So I think we care about free food because this program is so fucking expensive that we're trying to get the most of it.
So all my feelings taste like tender flake cold joy. My mom just called and she's appalled because my dad don't want a spoon. I take that spoon and put some ice cream on my afternoon. The guilty tastes like noodles. And lonely tastes like bread. But toast can make a loyal friend.
That's not so fortunate that my birthday is on the same week of Pablo, the like, best party guy in your class. So he hosted all of his birthday event, Asado, and I just, joined as a guest. But still, that's also my birthday, so everyone celebrated me. So yeah, I really like that, occasion. I was so lucky.
I was very scared that people at Harvard were like very geek, nerd, and they didn't like to dance, party, drink, and many other things. And that was a very great surprise. I was very, very scared that I was going to be the only one that really liked to drink pisco or other things. But I found like half of the class, the full class really likes to party hard, and I really like that. I realized that they're all nerds, but they care more about parties and everything else than just studying. That was a huge relief for me.
We kind of tried to introduce our Asian cultures and Asian music, especially Asian drinks, to you guys. Because like usually in the parties, they are all reggaetons and Indian music, and there was not many chance for us to play Asian music. Which is very good experience for me. So one time, like, I kind of introduced the Korean drinking song with the cocktail, the legend cocktail, No Pain No Gain. And then I was so touched when I saw people were singing ba-da-ba-da-ba, ba-da-ba-da-ba, ba-da-ba-ba-ba, one shot.
Ba-da-ba-da-ba, ba-da-ba-da-ba, one shot.
I mean, like, oh my god, it was incredible for me, to be fair. And then I kind of showed up to my Korean friends and, okay, look, my MPID friends are doing this. And then it was really mean to, like, a big thing to me. It really means to me a lot.
What is clear is that the MPID is a program where students study, learn, get experience, meet people, and drink coffee. But they also party. A lot. People have mentioned one person as the main responsible for giving alcohol to random people?
I'm not sure, but I think I had a chance to get water from Renzo.
He would always wait until I was drunk and then came to me with like two bottles of aguardiente and said, Kike, do your thing and give it to everyone. And, you know, haciéndole caso, doing what he told me to do, I almost once got blind by the famous Ina de Irrusiaga when I gave her water and she agreed and she spit it back in my face, in my eye. And then I was blind and then I looked at Renzo and I almost wanted to kill him, but still, Renzo Mini, I love him, love the guy.
I wanted to be here because I honestly felt like I needed to clean my name. Took the decision of not giving aguardiente to people. I'm just bringing it so that people make their own decision of drinking it or not. And I really like when people gather, when people are like getting to know each other, and why not gathering with an aguardiente, right? Or at an after party.
Ya, okay.
that students in the second year feel differently. Perhaps due to SAIPA, the new classes, the internship. False. It is because they're leaving soon. And the first years are here to remind them that.
I envy the people in the first year because they still have one whole year to go through this. We are living. The first year was amazing. The second one was also amazing, but my body doesn't hold that much firing as before. But still, I'm gonna miss a lot of things from this place.
What will I miss the most? Well, that's a deep question. Yeah. Sorry, I'm just having a bit of chest pain. There's no anxiety. Absolutely no anxiety in this.
Oh, excellent question. I think I'm gonna miss the community the most. I think over the last 2 years, especially the first year, we built such a bond based on shared trauma. And it's the last time we're ever going to be in a student environment like that where we can build such bonds. And so I'm gonna miss the closeness that I think we all feel going forward.
Yeah, it sounds really cliched when people say this, but I think I am going to miss the people. And I'll say why. I've really never in my life met a group and a cohort like this. And it's changed my life and my view of the world like in a very profound way, which also I'm still processing and I'm trying to understand.
Yeah, I will miss April's. Now we have that. We have had two amazing parties. We still have like three or four at least in April. And every time that I'll have a new April next year or like the following years, I think I will like remember the MPA ID times with a lot of like sadness and happiness at the same time.
Yeah, of course I miss the people most because, you know, we came from all over the world and it's not easy to, you know, see each other in person. So yeah, living here, I met like everyone almost every day. So like it's a kind of huge change from here to my life in Japan. So I really miss the people most. Yeah, I don't miss the class. I'm tired for study. So
I'll miss going into lunch hour, knowing that I find a lot of people I love in the cafeteria, and where we can talk about things, and then I will randomly break out in tears because I've been stressed lately.
What is very special from here is, although we all come from very different backgrounds, at the end, we keep saying ourselves that we want to change the world and we want to make a difference. And having that combination of, at least in our minds, the goal of making something different and also being nerds, I think it's a weird combination that doesn't happen all the time. And you put on that all the diversity of countries, cultures, backgrounds, all those things are, it's a very, very weird and rare space to just the people that are so similar to you but at the same time so diverse.
I mean, to be honest, the friendship that we have, some of the MBA friends who have not come past the river for a long time, I would miss them. I would miss my friends who I have not seen in a long time. I saw Dimitri the other day. I was very happy to see him. Probably the second time this semester. And maybe some other people like that who I haven't seen in a while, I would probably be happy to see them again. Because that's what I think I've gained the most from this MPID program. I mean, it's fine that you're learning about leadership, you're learning about economics. I mean, all that can wait, right? I mean, it's the friends who will give you that job, right? I mean, you learn about all these stuff, about all the kind of work that you want to do, World Bank and all that stuff, consulting, it's fine. I mean, but who will give you that job ultimately? It's your friends. 5 years down the line, they'll be the ones who'll be referring you. You'll be like, yes, Pranav, you should go for that job. They'll be the ones who'll give me that. So if anybody's listening to me, please, I am looking for a job right now. So in case you're up for it,
please DM.
We'll miss you guys. It's I can't imagine. Since I was only on campus for like 8 months before COVID, so you're like the first sign of life, and so it'll be sad when you guys leave. Yeah.
After having spent the previous fall teaching on Zoom, returning to the classroom with your class was incredibly special. I had spent a lot of time thinking about teaching on Zoom. I think you can teach on Zoom effectively. I even wrote this book about teaching on Zoom. But there's nothing that substitutes the human connection in a physical classroom. And your class returned that to me, and I will never forget that.
I can't specifically say that the class of 2023 is the greatest class of all time, but that may just be because other people in other classes will be mad at me. So, yeah.
My wish to your class is that life will bring both great moments and great challenges. My wish for your class is that you stay together as a class and that you're there for each other, both in the good and the bad times. It's easier to be together in the good times, but it's more important to be together in the challenging times. And I have no doubt that you will be there for each other, but life does present complications as you grow older and make different decisions, and I hope that you will prioritize remaining in touch. I am sure that you will be going to each other's weddings, that you will be helping each other professionally, and that you will be doing great things together, and I hope that that lasts for many, many years.
This documentary has come to an end, as same as the MPID. Many doubts still persist. For example, who is behind all this thing? Who is behind the program?
Okay, thank you for having me. I'm Carol Finney. I'm the director of the MPID program here at the Harvard Kennedy School, and I have been since its inception in the fall of 1999 when the first class entered. So, been here quite a while, and I've met a number of classes over the years. We're probably getting close to 2,000 alumni at this point. And yes, it's always good to think about the character of each individual class. Every class kind of has a different flavor, and you guys, with a little bit of COVID and changing things up, there's a particular closeness through that, and you guys have persisted through difficult times. So I really admire that about your class. And there's also a sense of humor and some real characters in your class. So I think I'll always think very fondly of the class of 2022.
But we are 2023.
Oh, wait a minute. 23? Who are you guys?
It was an early morning yesterday. I was up before the dawn, and I really have enjoyed my stay, but I must be moving on. Like a king without a castle, like a queen without a throne, I'm an early morning lover, and I must be moving on. Now I believe in what you say is the undisputed truth, but I have to have things my own way to keep me in my youth. Without an anchor, like a slave without a chain, just the thought of those sweet ladies as a chip out through my veins. And I will go on shining, shining like brand new. I'll never look behind. ocean. Just can't tell. There's some they will and some they won't, but some it's just as well.